नियतिकृतौ नियमरहितां क्लादैकमयीम् अनन्यपरतन्त्रां नवरसरुचिरां निर्मितिम् आदधति भारतीकवेर्जयति। नमस्ते लक्ष्मी, या लेट् मी 1 मिनिट्, मी टेक् अप् द बुक्। वि वर् लुकिङ्ग् एट् पददोष, वि स्टिल् हेव् टु डू वाट् इस् देट् अमुक् नन्यतत्पुरुषं, रैट्? नन्यसमास समासगतं इन् अविमृष्टविधेयांशं वि आर् लुकिङ्ग् एट् डिफ्रेण्ट् समासस्, बहुव्रीहि, वि फिनिश्ड् वित् वपुर्विरूपाक्षम्, अलक्ष्यजन्मता, दिगम्बरत्वेन निवेदितं वसु, वरेषु यद्बालमृगाक्षि मृग्यते तदस्ति किं व्यस्तमपि त्रिलोचने। That's the shloka where we stopped, and it was the Bahuvrihi samasa that we saw. Now in the Nanya samasa, he gives us only one example. Ananda Sindhu Rati Chapala Shali Chitta Sandananaika Sadanam Kshanamapyamukta Ya Sarvadeva Bhavata Tadudanta Chinta Tantim Tanoti Tava Samprati Dhik Dhik Asman. So, he actually talks, gives us one example and then gives two counter examples as to how the nan can be used properly and how it should be used properly in a samasa. So when we look at this nan samasa, usually the pradhanam should be for the nishedha, and if it is in a samasa, the nishedha does not get prominence. So if I say anashvaha, yaha ashvaha na bhavati saha, so it is still the pradhana is for the vastu or the jantu that is being indicated by the word anashvaha. The negation is not a pradhana there. The pratishedha is not pradhana there in a samasa, so it loses the prominence. So you can use that nan in a samasa where you do not want to give emphasis on the nishedha, but you want to give emphasis to the resulting product or the person who is being indicated by that samasa. Then it is okay. But if we need to, that is called paryudasa. So there are two types of nan, which is one is prasajya pratishedha, the other is paryudasaha. Now this prasajya pratishedha means where the nan is connected to a kriya. Na karoti, na patati, na gayati, I cannot, or na tyajati. For example, in the shloka, he says amukta, na munchati, so na tyakta. So instead of saying na tyakta, he has used it in the samasa where the prominence for the nishedha is lost. Hence, there is a dosha here. What is the vidheya? And we have to look at what is the vidheya and uddeshya. Let's look at the shlokam meaning and then we will go to the, I will again tell you how the nishedha works here. So, ananda sindhu, ati chapala shali chitta sandanana ekasadanam, sa kshanam api amukta, ya sarvadeiva bhavata tadudanta chinta tantim tanoti itava. Samprati dhik dhik asman. So a sakhi comes and informs an nayaka about the status of the nayika. So the nayika's sakhi comes to the nayaka and tells him how she is constantly thinking about you and she has become very thin. So tantim tanoti, she is extremely thin now. Krishatvam tanoti sa, glanim tanoti. We are to be blamed. Dik dik asman. We are to be blamed for that status of hers, because she is constantly thinking only about you. So asmat sakhi ya sarvadeiva bhavata amukta. So it's a very difficult shloka to, say anvayam and say the meaning also. That Nayika is Ananda Sindhu. She is like an ocean of happiness for you. Ati Chapala Shali Chitta Sandanana Ekasadanam. She is like the only place, or she is the like a repository for your chittam, and she binds your mind together. And Ati Chapala Shali, she is also very fickle minded, or she's and so in this wait, 1 minute, let's see. So Chapalya Gunakaranena Tava Chittam Sabadhnati, that is the meaning for that. So because she is very fickle, or she is she's got a very attractive quality, she has come into your mind. She has attracted your mind. Tadrisha, Tadrishi Naika, Naika. What is he trying to say about her? You did not forsake her. Namukta. Sa Kshanamapi Twaya Namukta. Bhavata Namukta. Instead of Namukta, he is using Amukta here. She has not been, she's always thinking of you, and she was not left by you, forsaken by you even for a moment. Kshanamapi Amukta Sa. Why? Because she is the ocean of bliss, like Sri Ananda Sindhu. Ati Chapala Shali Chittasya. This chittam is constantly moving. It can fix its mind on any person. So it is fickle minded. For the fickle mind, she is like one Eka Sadhana. She has bound your heart towards her. So she has come and sat there in your mind. Tadrishi sa kshanamapi twaya amukta. She has not been left by you. Ya sa naika sarvadeiva tadudanta chinta. She is always thinking about you. Your tava vrittantasya chintanam ya karoti sa tadudanta chinta tantim tanoti. She is constantly, she's become very thin because of that. Or you can say tadudanta chinta aduna tava tantim karoti. You can take it in this way also, because these are all small shlokas. The anvaya can be difficult, the anvaya can be made in two different ways. That's why I keep going back and forth. So it can also mean to a person who was initially fixed upon her, and now he is not looking at her. So even her name is giving him an aruchi. So when the sakhis go to that Nayaka and they're talking to him about her and saying, you know, she was your happiness, Ananda Sindhuhusa, and Ati Chapala Shali Chitta, she had taken place in your heart for a long time, and Kshanamapi Amukta, you had not left her even for a moment. Tadrishi Sa, you know, she was like that for you. Now today, Samprati, what happens? The tadudanta chinta, the moment we talk about that Nayika to you, tava tantim tanoti, you are also having a glani. Tanti can mean aruchi, tanti can also mean glanti, tanutvam, it can mean both. So it can apply to the Nayika also, it can apply to the Nayika also. So here you can see, the moment we talk about her name, her very name gives you a unpleasantness in your mind, then, which means dikdik asmana, we have not done our work properly. We should have, you know, made sure that the both of you are staying together. We did not do our work properly. So that is one thing. So the first, our dosha here is only in the first sentence. So the first sentence is where kshanamapi amukta sa. So kshanamapi sa na tyakta is what it has to be mentioned there. Atra na mukta iti nishedaha videya. Now what is the videyamsha and the uddeshyamsha? Uddeshyamsha is someone, you're talking of somebody. And then the, say, sa is your uddeshyamsha. And what is the videyamsha? Uddeshyamsha is the nyatamsha, that which we know before, which is the naika, sa. The agnyatamsham is something which we are introducing at this point, which is your Vidheyamsha, right? That is your Vidheyam and Uddeshyam. And if the Vidheyamsha does not gain prominence, then it is Avimrishta Vidheyamsha, correct? So here the Vidheyamsha should be Nishedha. She was not left by you at all. You were so attentive to her before, is the idea that she wants to say here, correct? Or you were extremely endearing to her that now she is suffering glani or tanutvam. Here, na mukta has to be used separately for the na to be a vidheyamsha. Or mukta, you can say that when it is attached to the kriya, when I say sa patati, she is reading, sa na patati, then which means that na gains prominence. Apatanti sa kim karoti, there is always a question of something else which becomes prominent. So when I say sa patati, there sa is the uddeshyamsha and patati, the kriya, becomes the vidheyamsha. Okay, now inside that, if we put in a negation or a nishedha there, the na becomes the vidheyamsha, which is what you are trying to emphasize on. That is called prasajya pratishedha. So the definition of that prasajya pratishedha, 1 minute, let me just take that out and apradhanyam videhe yatra pratishedhe pradhanata, pratishede pradhanata prasajya pratishedo asau kriyaya saha yatra nanya. That is important. So kriyaya saha yatra kriyanvayi nanya vartate tatraiva prasajya pratishedaha iti nayaha arthaha. The definition of prasajya pratishedha nanya is where the nanya has to be associated with the kriya anvayitvam tatra nayaha. Which means the dhatvartasya abhavarupaha bodhitaha atra. Abhavaha eva pradhanam. If the abhava is important, if you put it inside the samasa, here what happens is amukta sa, if there still exists a question mark, what are you talking about her? So which means amukta becomes the uddeshyamsha. It is no longer the Vidheyamsha and it expects a Vidheyamsha elsewhere, which is absent here. Okay. I hope it's clear. If there is a doubt, then just ask me. Now, the other, either you have to use it with the Kriya, or if you use it within a samasa, there should be a pradhana kriya, another pradhana kriya in the shloka. So he is going to give two counter examples. So the next shloka is where he says yatha. So na atra na mukta iti nishedaha vidheyaha. Nishedamsha should be the vidheyamsha here. Yatha, just like in the following shloka. In the following shloka, he clearly states how it has to be used in the shloka. So navajaladharaha sannadhoyam nadrupta nishacharaha suradhanuridam durakrishtam natasya sharasanam ayamapi paturdharasaraha nabana parampara kanaka nikasha snigdha vidyut priya namama urvashi. This is in the fourth anka of Vikramorvashiyam. Here nishedha pradhanyam and samasa abhavam is being shown here. That is, there is no dosha in the shlokam. It is a counter example where there is no dosha. In fact, it is a guna, and the nishedha or the nanya has to be used in this manner. And if it is used in this manner, then it is proper. The context here is Pururvas is describing the megha. So someone is thinking that it could be a nishacharaha, it could be a rakshasa. So he's trying to negate that and say that nava jaladharaha sannaddaha. There is a new megha that is here. It is not na dripta nishacharaha, it is not that arrogant rakshasa. So you can't say adripta nishacharaha. If you say that adripta nishacharaha nava jaladharaha rajate, means then it becomes different. Your negation does not gain prominence, but something else it will be get prominence. Whereas here he wants to say that it is not a nishachara, it is not a rakshasa, it is in fact a cloud, right? So nava jaladharaha, a rain cloud, sannaddaha, it is ready here. बट् इट् इस् नाट् अ दृप्त निशाचरः. सो न दृप्त निशाचरः इत्युक्ते तत्र दृप्त निशाचरः न भवति इति क्रिया अन्वयित्वं वर्तते. यु हाव् टु कनेक्ट् इट् एट् एव्रि पायिण्ट् यु हाव् टु से न भवति. ओके, नञ् विल् इट्स् आल्वेस् बेटर् टु अण्डर्स्टाण्ड् इट् बै कनेक्टिङ्ग् वित् क्रिया आर् इट् शुड् बि इन् अ समास. नेक्स्ट्, सुरधनुः इदं दूराकृष्टं सुरधनुः न तस्य शरासनं. दिस् इस् सुरधनुः, इट् इस् इन्द्रधनुस् आर् रेन्बो एण्ड् बट् नाट् दट् निशाचर दट् राक्षसस् शरासनं. तस्य निशाचरस्य शरासनं आर् बो धनुः न अस्ति आर् न भवति. अयमपि पटुः धारासारः. सो ड्यूरिङ्ग् अ रेनी सीसन् यु विल् सी अ रेन् क्लौड्, देर् विल् बि अ रेन्बो आन् वन् सैड्, देर् विल् बि वृष्टि rain, and then there is also the lightning, vidyut. So each one he describes in each line. So navajaladaras sannadhoyam na driptan rishacharah suradhanuhu idam dura krishtam, that which has been pulled far. Dura akrishtam dhanuhu, suradhanuhu means the bow of the devas, which is your rainbow. Na tasya sharasanam, it is not that nishacharas bow. Ayamapi patuh, this expert dhara sarah, this fast pouring rain, it is tivraha dhara sarah varsha asti natu bana parampara, it is not the force of arrows that come from the bow. Kanaka nikasha snigdha vidyut na mama urvashi, it is not my urvashi. So urvashi was taken away by the rakshasa, so with that brahma he is looking at the see, she is not there, so he thinks that probably he has been taken away by the rakshasa when he looks at the sky, and then for the first moment he thinks it is the rakshasa who is taking away urvashi and fighting. Then he negates all of those and says, no, no, this is not the Rakshasa, it is a cloud. It is not the Rakshasa's bow, it is the rainbow. It is not the Bana Parampara, Kintu Dhara Saraha, Dhara Varsha, Varshaha. Kanaka Nikasha Snigdha, very beautiful, like the Kanaka Nikasha, like a, Nikasha means like a ray of gold. A streak of gold, it's not, it's very beautiful streak of gold is actually vidyut, it is lightning, natu mama priya urvashi, and it is not my beloved urvashi. Ityatra natu amuktata anuvadena anyat atra kinchit vihitam. Here amuktata, see, the word amukta in the previous shloka has become anuvada. Anuvada is anudyam, that which is being said again. It is not the vidheyam. Anudyate means it is something that is known. Jnatamshaha is anudyam. Vidheyamshaha, ajnatamshaha. So here what happens is amuktata anuvadena anyat atra kinchit vihitam iti na. The nany that is there in the first of the sentence, you always have to take it, iti na bhavati, at the end. So let us discount the na and look at the statement. He says is amuktata anuvadena. Just like how amukta has been used in the previous shloka, in the Ananda Sindhu shloka, that amukta, not being forsaken by him, what did she do? It expects another thing. Anyat atra kinchit vihitam, which we need something else to indicate. That situation is not present in this shloka, Navajaladaras Sannadhoyam. Okay, so amuktata anumadena anyat atra vidhiyate anyat kinchit vihitam vidhiyate iti videyamshaha kaschana apekshitaha iti asmin shloke navartate. Apekshana vartate tatra. So whereas in the previous shloka, amukta ityukte vidheyamshaha kaha iti prashnaha udeti. Okay. Now this is an example for prasajya pratishedha, where the nan is connected with the kriya and said. So dripta nishacharaha na bhavati, sharasanam na bhavati, bana parampara na bhavati, urvashi na asti or na bhavati. In the same way, yatha जुगोप आत्मानम् अत्रस्तः भेजे धर्ममनातुरः अगृध्रुर् आददे सः अर्थान् आसक्तः सुखमन्वभूत् इत्यत्र अत्रस्तत्वाद्यनुवादेन आत्मनः गोपनादि. लेट्स लुक एट द श्लोक फर्स्ट. दिस इज अबाउट दिलीपाल्य. I think it is in the second sarga of prathama sarga of Raghuvamsha, where he is describing Dilipa. Atrastaha jugopa atmanam, atmanam jugopa. He covered, that is, he hid himself from the people, not exactly hid, he actually protected himself. Jugopa atrastaha, he was not afraid of anybody, that he had to cover himself or hide himself. Even though he was not afraid of anybody, he still guarded himself. Jugopa means actually covering oneself or hiding oneself. But here atrastaha, you usually hide yourself from someone if you are afraid of someone. Whereas Dilipa, he was atrastaha, he was not at all afraid, yet he guarded himself well, because he was a king and he had to guard himself from any of the enemies. So jugopa atmanam atrastaha. So here atrastaha, not being fearful, without being terrified or without being fearful, he hid himself. Now here atrastaha, even though there is a negation here, the negation is not important for us. Tattu anuvadena atrastatvam ityatra anuvadaha. So it is being said, he is not afraid, that we know. So without being afraid, what did he do? It still expects a videyamsha, and there the videyamsha is jugopa. आत्मनः गोपनं तत्र विधीयते अत्रस्तत्वं तु उद्देश्यांशः. द सेम वे नेक्स्ट वन, अनातुरः धर्मं भेजे. एनीबडी, द मोमेंट यू गेट अ रोगम, यू विल गो एंड स्टार्ट डूइंग धर्म. यू विल थिंक दैट देयर इज सम प्रॉब्लम विद माय जातकम, सम पूर्व कर्म इज अटैकिंग मी, दैट इज व्हाई आई हैव दिस रोगम, दैट्स व्हाई माय चिल्ड्रन आर सफरिंग, माय हस्बैंड इज सफरिंग, माय फादर इन लॉ, मदर इन लॉ, फादर, मदर. यू देन यू विल गो टू द ज्योतिषम एंड स्टार्ट डूइंग धर्म. दे विल से गो टू दिस पुण्यस्थलम, गिव दिस दानम, एक्सेट्रा एक्सेट्रा. हियर धर्मम भेजे, दिलीपा वॉज नॉट ऑफ दैट काइंड ऑफ अ पर्सन, ही वॉज नॉट अ नॉर्मल पर्सन. अनातुरः, even though he was not troubled by anything, be it adhi vyadhi, whether it is adhi or manovyadhi or physical problems, he still followed a very righteous path. Dharmam bheje. Next is agridruho adade arthan. Once you start getting wealth, you will be greedy for getting more and more. You will not be enough with, okay, let me look at the bank balance, it is 10,000. No, let me have one more zero to it. Then one more zero to it. One more zero. You will always be greedy. Artham is such that it makes you, you don't know when you are doing it for survival and when it moves into being greedy and then it moves into avarice. You are being more and more greedy there. Right, that is a normal pathway. Dilipa being different from normal people, agridhnuhu, without being greedy, arthana adade, he took wealth from people. It's a tax, right? So he was not greedy and he did not want to possess that money. He used it for people, for dharma. So agridhnuhu, the whole thing is connected in such a manner. Let me finish the shlokam and then go there. So asaktaha sukham anvabhut, he enjoyed a sukha, happiness, without being attached to it. If you want to enjoy happiness, you should have luxury, but that luxury also he got it only to perform dharma. Only if you guard yourself really well, you will not be troubled by anything, and then he can perform dharma. To perform dharma, he needs wealth. And then with that wealth, he also enjoyed sukham without being attached to it. The whole thing is well connected with between each other. So it also shows that he was a very good king. He was a righteous king. He was also, he had a lot of wealth which he used for dharma, and he was not greedy to possess that wealth. is basically a very happy person, but not too attached to the enjoyments that he was he had to. Because Yavvane Visheshinam is only a character that is there for the Raghuvamsha kings during the Yavvana. They have to pursue those pleasures in the world, and they did it at that point of time. With a mindful action, it was a mindful action, right? They proceeded with their work in a very mindful manner. That is, their mind was always with the dharma. Okay, now it will become a Raghuvamsha lecture now. Jugopa atmanam atrastaha bheje dharma manaturaha agridruhu adade saha arthan asaktaha sukham anvabhut. So asaktaha, without getting attached to the wealth, he was enjoying his wealth. Now here, enjoying sukham. Each of those words in each of the padam is atrastaha, anaturaha, agridnuhu, and asaktaha. All these four words are yaha trastaha na bhavati saha. So that nishedha is there inside that samasa. Anaturaha, yaha aturaha na asti. Agridnuhu, na yaha agridnuhu na asti. Saktaha na asti. So again, all these samasa have that nishedha within it, yet it is not the pradhanam. We don't want it as a pradhanam, and it becomes the uddeshyamsha, whereas the videyamsha is atmanam jugopa. That verb becomes more prominent, and that is your pradhanamsham, which is the videyamsha. Okay, and the same way, anaturaha being the nishedha, so what he is essentially trying to say is, you should either, when you are using nan, you should either use it like the former, where you connect it with the kriya, saying na bhavati, na asti, etc., etc., or you have to use that nan where something else is pradhana and it is not pradhana. In the Ananda Sindhu example, he wanted to use it as na tyakta. He wanted to say that na nishedha is the videyamsha, whereas he used it in the samasa and made it apradhana, without another videyamsha in the shloka. Got it? Okay. Now with this, avimrushta videyamsha is over. The last padadosha is viruddham atikrit. And he gives four examples for this. There is no specific reason as to how many types of viruddham atikrit is there. There can be many different examples, and as in how you read kavyas, you will be able to understand that. So mainly viruddhamati krite is also samasagatam and not just padagatam. Sudhakara karakara visharada vicheshtitaha akaryamitrameko asau tasya kim varnayamahe. So he is talking of a person who is akaryamitra. Akaryamitra means a person without any selfish motive. So karyam vina yaha mitram bhavati saha akaryamitraha. So karyam vina means without see, there are people who say, oh, you are my best friend, but they will always want something in exchange. It's not a deal. So he is not a friend who always puts a deal with another person. Saha akaryamitraha. Now, in this samasa is such a way that you can also split it and say it is akarye yaha mitram. So that person who is akarye, who is a friend in actions that should not be done, akarye, or in bad actions. When in criminal, you know, a friend who is a criminal, right? That is an akarya mitra. So the meaning totally is opposite to what he is trying to say. So viruddha matikrita actually means where viruddha anuchitartham comes up in your mind. Not anuchitartham, then it will be a problem with another dosha. What we are going to say is prakritartha pratibandhakam happens. So the prakritartha, wait, in the Vyakhyana he says prakritartha pratibandhaki bhuta अप्रकृतार्थ धी जनकं विरुद्धमतिकृत् इज द परफेक्ट डेफिनेशन ऑफ विरुद्धमतिकृत् दिस प्रकृतार्थ इज कॉन्टेक्चुअल मीनिंग द कॉन्टेक्चुअल मीनिंग इज बीइंग stopped or there is an obstacle for us to understand the contextual meaning and a viruddha mati viruddha jnanam utpadyate there is an aprakritartha or that which is not the contextual you have to first fix the context where you have to check out whether this man is praising this friend or not if he is praising this friend then the meaning would be karyam vina mitram that is only vivakshitam but when he says akarya mitram asau the idea that immediately comes up in our mind is something totally different from what he wishes to convey which means he is a partner in crime that's what it means right so the shloka meaning is sudhakara kara sudhakara chandra chandrasya kiranah karaha kiranam akara just kirana swaroopa visharada you can say it is white vicheshtita a person who is whose actions are as pure or as white which means pure so he does not mix any criminal activities in his actions so vicheshtitah yasya vicheshtitah that friends whose action is visharada pure like akara like sudhakara kara like the moon's rays tasya kim varnayamahe what do I say, what do I describe about such a person who is ekaha asau eva akarya mitram? Only this person is akarya mitram, an unselfish friend. That is the idea he wants to convey. But what does he say instead? He says, uses the word in a samasa, so it is samasa gatam. And the meaning that is getting conveyed is akarya mitram means you are a friend in criminal activities that is the idea so atra karyam vina mitram iti vivakshitam that is the idea that the poet wishes to convey because when he says sudhakara kara akara visharada cheshtitah means he has got very pure actions that is the context that is being fixed but the word akarya mitra tries to it's as if it is suggesting us so akarye mitram iti tu pratitihi bhavati this is samasagatam next one namapadam it is not about the samasa but it is how the word itself has no problem but when it is used inside the samasa then there is a problem whether it is akaryam itself means karyam vina and akarya that is yatu na karyam bhavati tat it can also na karyam iti akaryam or karyam yatra nasti iti akaryam so the samasa itself gives a problem in the next example what he takes is the samasa does not give two meanings but the meaning of the word that is being used gives us a wrong meaning let's look at the example and you'll understand chirakala paripraapta lochananda dayinaha kanta kantasya sahasa vidadati galagraham Nayika is seeing her Nayaka after a long time. So she immediately goes and hugs him, embraces him. So meeting after a long time, Chirakala Pariprapta Lochana Ananda Dayinaha Kantasya. Lochana Abhyam, Kantaha, beloved is giving Ananda. He gives happiness. He gives happiness to her eyes. Because she is meeting him after a long time. Chirakala pariprapta lochana anandadayinaha kantasya galagraham vidadati. Galagraham is kantha graham. Gala is kantha. So she is literally falling on his neck or embracing him. Sahasa immediately kanta the beloved naika galagraham vidadati. She is alinganam karoti. Now here the word problem word is galasya graham or kantasya graham kantha graham actually means alinganam gala graham by yoga rudi it has come to mean any problem with the throat it is a roga of the throat maybe sore throat or laryngitis whatever any ayurveda specialist would be able to say that it is a any disorder throat disorder is supposed to be termed as Galagraha. Kavi does not use Galagraha in place of Kanthagraha. For Alinganam, you never use the word Galagraha because it has come to mean any problem that is associated with the throat. So which means it is a roga. Okay, atra kantagraham iti vachyam. Kantagraham only can convey the meaning of alinganam, whereas galagraham can only mean a particular disease of the neck or the throat, which is actually completely opposite of what you want to say. She gives him throat disease is what the imagery that will come into our mind. That is not what we want. Correct? We want to know, it's totally Shringara, where we want Shringara, that she is embracing him, the idea comes about as Bibatsa or Bhaya, he has got disease. Correct? We don't want that idea. So Chirakala Pariprapta Lochananandada. Here the Galagraha, there is no problem with the Samasa as such, like how in Akarya Mitram we saw Karyam Vina Api Mitram or Akarye Yaha Mitram, there is a problem with the interpreting of that Samasa itself, and that is why we had the Avivakshita Vachyarthasya Pratitihi Abhavat. Whereas here, it is not with the Galagraha, the samasa that is the problem, because Galasya Graham or Kanthasya Graham, both are the same only samasa, there is no issues there, but that Yoga Rudi is the problem. It has come to mean, like how when we say Pankajam, nobody talks about a worm. It is Pankate Jayate. Anything that comes out of mud is called a Pankajaha, means then it will mean a worm. But Yoga Rudhi means, by popular convention, even though there is an etymological derivation for the word, by popular convention, Pankaja means only lotus. In the same manner, Galagraha, even though there is an etymological derivation for it, this Galagraha has come to mean only a disease. Okay? Yathava, another example he gives is, Natrastam Yadinama Bhuta Karuna Santana Shantatmanaha Tenam Vyarujata Dhanur Bhagavato Devat Bhavani Patehe Tatputrastu Madandha Taraka Vadhati Vishwasya Dattot Savaha Skanda Skanda Iva Priyo Aham Athava Shishyaha Katham Vismritaha. In Mahavira Charitam, this comes in the Dvitiyanka. Bhavabhuti has written three beautiful drama. And one of that is called Mahavira Charitam, where the Veera Rasa is the Pradhanam here. Parashurama hears that Rama has broken Shiva's dhanus. Lord Shiva's disciple, correct? The moment he hears that Shiva's bow has been destroyed, he comes there in order to... it's like he has to uphold the dignity of his guru. Someone has shown a disrespect towards his guru, so he comes there with a force of anger and he wants to protect the dignity of his guru. Chhatra, the word chhatra itself, 1 minute, it's a very beautiful vyutpatti. Yes, chhatram iva acharati is the lakshana. There is actually a sutram which says chhatra divyaha naha. From chhatra, the word chhatra has come. So it is actually mutual, where guruna shishyaha chhatravate chhadyaha. He has to be covered by the guru. The guru protects the shishya also protects the guru. So the word chhatra can mean both, it seems. In Mahabhashyam he says shishyenapi guruhu chhatrameva paritratavyaha paripalya.
Oh. Oh, very nice.
Very lovely etymology. So Parashurama, he has to protect his guru's dignity. And so he arrives there and he says, didn't you even think of Shiva? How when you destroyed the bow of Shiva, Bhavani Patehe Bhagavataha Bhavani Patehe Dhanuhu Vyarujata Tena Natrastam Yadinama. He's talking to actually... he just enters and says this shloka. So he's indicating Rama and saying, Tena Ramena Bhagavataha Dhanuhu Vyarujata Nashayata, by destroying, or Bhagnam Kurvata, by destroying Shiva's bow, didn't he wasn't he afraid to do that? Bhayam na asid na trastam yadi nama. And how is that? The adjective that he puts for Shiva is bhuta karuna santana shanta atmana. See, he's a very quiet person, a very calm person. Shiva is shanta atmana. Why? Bhuta karuna santana. Bhuteshu karuna santana asti tasya. He is extremely dayapurnaha saha bhuteshu. For all people, he shows his daya and hence he is always shantaha indriya nigraha karoti. So he won't react for all this. But aren't you afraid that he is capable of doing anything? Bhavani patihi. He is actually Durga's pati. Bhavani, Durga's pati, so he is capable of anger and you have destroyed his dhanuhu. Bhagavataha bhuta karuna santana shanta atmanaha bhavani patehe dhanuhu vyarujata. So by trying to destroy the bow of Bhavani pati, who is very calm by nature, because he has so much of daya towards the entire world, don't you feel even a little bit of fright? Na tarastam yadi nama. That is fine. Okay. Because he is very calm and he won't react. Think about his son. Tat putrastu. How is his son? Mada andha madandha taraka vadhat vishwasya datta utsavaha. He gave a great happiness to the entire world by killing Vadhat, by killing Tarakasura, who was Mada Andha, who was blinded by the ego that he had, by his arrogance. So blinded by his arrogance, Taraka was destroying the entire world, and Skandaha, Tatputraha, he datta utsavaha, datta anandaha, lokasya, vishwasya. He gave a great happiness to the entire world by destroying Tarakasura. Okay. Forget him. Skanda eva priyaha aham tasya shishyaha katham vismritaha. How did you forget me, who is almost equal? Shishyaha is also equal to putraha, because when you grow up in the gurukulam, putra is also treated like a shishya, shishya is also treated like a putra. So skanda eva priyaha aham. I am as beloved to Shiva as is Skanda, Kartikeya. So aham athava shishyaha katham vismritaha. How did you forget the two of us? Either his, you should have remembered his son. You would have thought about the consequences of breaking the bow, Shiva's bow. Because one, he is Bhavani pati. Number two, his son is Kartikeya, who has destroyed Tarakasura. Or third, you would have remembered me. Aham is actually an Arthantara Sankramita Atsiddhani, where he says, I, Parashurama, has destroyed the entire Kshatriya race. Think of the avatara karanam of Parashurama, and that is, he says, aham skandaiva priyaha aham tasya shishyaha katham vismrita. Okay, now the problem here is hatra bhavani pati iti shabdaha bhavanyaha patyantare pratitim karoti. The problem is, see, the word bhavani, there are two opinions about this shloka. There is no dosha is one opinion, where Bhavani means Durga. It is indicatory of Durga. So Durga Patihi, in fact, is a Parikara Alankara, where the Visheshana is pregnant with meaning. And because he is Durga Pati, he may have a very calm countenance, very calm exterior, but he is in fact Durga's Pati. And he is capable of anger, so you should have thought about the consequences. So it is a guna in one way. Another way to explain this is, Bhavani is not Rudhya Durga ityarthe, kintu you can look at the etymology of the word and say, Bhavasya Patni iti Bhavani. Pumyogata, you have Nish Pratyaya here. And so Bhavaha is Shivaha. So Bhavani Shivasya Patni. When we say Shivasya Patnyaha Patihi, then it might indicate that there is another Pati for Bhavani. So, Bhavasya Patnyaha Patihi ityukte Shivahana Kintu Patyantare Pratitim Karoti. Hence, that will totally bring down the meaning of this shloka or bring down the importance of it, and your mind will aruchihi jayate. Viruddham atikriti means vivakshitartha is not there, and there is a distaste that arises immediately when you get that meaning, right? So one aspect is, or one way to look at it is, some people say that bhavani rudyartha, even though there is an etymological derivation of saying bhavasya patni bhavani, even though it is like that, the bhavani shabdasya durga durgatve rudhi, which is by popular convention we just take up bhavani as durga. Okay, that is the dosha he points out. Don't think of the gunam, because for the context you need to know what is the dosha. So what is the dosha here? Bhavani bhavasya pati bhavasya patni bhavani भवान्याः पतिः इत्युक्ते भवान्याः पत्यन्तरे इन्स्टेड् आफ् शिवा, शिवात् अन्यः, यु विल् थिङ्क् आफ् सम् अदर् पति, दट् इस् युवर् प्राब्लम्. यथा वा वेरि सिमिलर् टु दिस् इस् द नेक्स्ट् श्लोक, गोरपि यत् वाहनतां प्राप्तवतः सोऽपि गिरिसुता सिंहः सविधे निरहङ्कारः पायात् वः सो अम्बिकारमणः. In the previous shloka we saw it is actually pada vayarthyam, in the sense the idea of making bhavani itself is not necessary. You can use, he could have used just bhavasya. To make it as bhavani patihi is actually, there is no prayojanam for using that word. The next one is, there are two meanings for that samasa, and hence there is a problem. Just like in akarya mitram, here also he is going to point out one problem there. Ambika Ramanaha, that is the word, that is the issue. So let's look at the meaning of the shloka. Gorapi yat vahanatam praptavataha goho, yad vahanatam praptavataha goho, so api girisuta simhaha savidhe nirahankaraha goho savidhe सः गिरिसुतः सिंहः अपि निरहङ्कारः सः अम्बिकारमणः वः पायात्. मेन् सेण्टेन्स् हियर् इस् अम्बिकारमणः, अम्बिका पार्वती, पार्वत्याः रमणः शिवः, शिवः वः पायात्. लेट् शिव प्रोटेक्ट् यू आल् इस् द मेन् सेण्टेन्स्. इन् हूस् प्रेसेन्स् द नियर् द कौ दट् सिंह दट् इस् गिरि गौरीस् वाहनम् इस् द सिंहः. That simha, its natural enemy is a cow or an ox. Here, Shiva's vahanam is Vrishabham. Even though both of them, there is a nice shlokam where there is an enmity between simha and gauhu, enmity between mayura and naga, and then the simha and gaja. But all of these exist, and the snake and the mouse, correct? There is an enmity between all of these animals. But all of these animals stayed together in this family without any showing any enmity, correct? Mayura vahanaha kartikeyaha, mushika vahanaha saha, sarpa is an abharanam for Shiva, and he has gaja charma. Or even Ganesha is Gajamukhaha, Durga's Vahanam is Simha. So all of these exist in harmony in their, actually the poet will say, I don't know how you manage your family with so much of internal conflicts. That is what the poet will say in the shloka. I forget the shloka. It's a nice Shubhashitam. So here in this shloka he says, Yat Vahanatam, no, 1 minute. The anvayam is very different. Saha ambika ramanaha vaha payat yat vahanatam yasya maheshasya vahanatam praptavataha goho savidhe samipe. The simha, girisuta simhaha, the lion which is Parvati's, that lion stands near stands near the bull, ओके गोहो सविधे एंड दैट गोहो यद वाहनतां प्राप्तवतः द बुल विच इज एक्चुअली बिकम द वाहनम फॉर शिवा एंड नियर दैट दिस गौरीज लायन इज एक्चुअली स्टैंडिंग विदाउट एनी एनिमिटी सो सविधे निरहंकारः इट इज स्टैंडिंग देयर विदाउट एनी अहंकार सह अंबिकारमणः दैट शिवा शुड प्रोटेक्ट यू ऑल मे ही प्रोटेक्ट यू ऑल पायात got the meaning of the shlokam right so atra ambika ramanaha iti viruddham dhiyam utpadayati the idea here is ambika amba eva ambika amba is mother and ambika is also mother only amba eva ambika iti vyutpatti not parvati ambika does not can, need not mean parvati but ambika can mean mother so ambika ramanaha A lover of your mother means it is a very nice picture in the mind where the mother has another affair with somebody else. That is what it indicates. So instead of thinking of Parvati's husband, you will be thinking of a secret lover of your mother. So that is the viruddha dhihi that comes about in the mind. सो अत्र अंबिका रमणः इति विरुद्धां धियम् उत्पादयति इट क्रिएट्स अ डिफरेंट नॉट डिफरेंट बट टोटली अनएक्सेप्टेबल इमेज इन आवर माइंड सो दैट्स व्हाई ही दैट अंबिका शब्द इज आल्सो मातृवाचक पदम दैट इज व्हाई दैट्स अ प्रॉब्लम दैट्स द दोष हियर नाउ विद दिस वी हैव फिनिश्ड समासगतम फॉर क्लिष्ट अविमृष्ट विधेयांश एंड विरुद्धमति कृते समासगतम कैन बी फॉर श्रुतकटु श्रुतिकटु एंड ऑल दैट आल्सो वी सॉ दैट बिफोर आई थिंक राइट वेयर डिड वी सी दैट इन दैट समास ही सेड इन द प्रीवियस श्लोक ही सेड केवलम समासगतम च So the Shruti Katu, etc., those can be in Samasa also. And he gives only one example for that Shruti Katu in a Samasa. And then he moves on to Padad Vakya Dosha. So let's finish with that shlokam. Shruti Katu, Samasa Gatam, Yatha. He does not give us examples for all of those doshas which can occur in Samasa. Actually, the doshas that can occur in Samasa are... Where is that? Shruti katu, chuta samskriti, aprayuktam, asamartham, nihatartha, anichitartha, nirarthaka, avachaka, ashlila, sandigdha, apratita, gramya, and neyartha. All of these 13 can occur in both padakatam, samasagatam cha. But he is only giving us shruti katu as an example. The rest is left to you. So, sa durecha sudha sandra tarangita vilochana, बर्हि निर्हरादनार्हो दैट इट्सेल्फ गिव्स अस दैट इट इज श्रुति कटु वी आर टॉकिंग ऑफ श्रृंगार हियर बर्हि निर्हरादन अर्हः अयम् कालः च समुपागतः अयम् कालः समुपागतः दिस टाइम इज नाउ हैज अराइव्ड विच इज बर्हि निर्हरादन अर्हः द टाइम दैट gives happiness to the or the time arhaha which is yogya for barhi nirhradana mayura krandanasya uchitaha kalaha atra samagataha tasyaha sa sudha sandra tarangita vilochana sa dure vartate I am completely separated from my lover who is Sudha Sandra Tarangita Vilochana, whose eyes are Tarangita, which has graceful glances, and Sudha Sandra, which is very endearing like Sudha, Amrita. Amrita Iva Sandra Ruchikara Tarangita Vilochana. She has a lot of these hav-bhav and beauty that is there in her glances. And Naika sa mama priya dure sthita asti kintu adhuna varsha samayaha atra vartate which means his viraha is going to be intensified now here we want the viraha to be intensified and not to krodha or raudram here correct So the Varsha Kalam is here and I miss her too much, and that love in separation has to be described here. Whereas Barhi Nirhradana Arhaha is Shruti Katu and it is very harsh sounding. Now this is not Padagatam, whereas it is Samasagatam. It is in that Samasa where three words are joined together. Barhi is peacock, Nirhradana Krandana, it's shouting, cries, Arha Yogya. Because it is that Shruti Katutvam is present in all three words and it is in a samasam. This is an example for samasagata Shruti Katu. Okay. Evam anyadapi jneyam. Now you have to think of this in Chuta Samskriti, etc., etc. Also, so he doesn't give us, bother us with examples for all of that. Whereas if you read Sahitya Darpanam, he will give us examples for everything, both samasagatam, padagatam, vakyam, padamsham. He goes in details and gives us examples for those doshas. Next, we have to take up vakya dosha. We'll do that next class. There is no class on Thursday.